All right, guys, so I want to start shooting some videos using the heavy bag. Now, again, like, so this video is more of a intro video, so if you are experienced with the heavy bag, you might want to skip this one. However, I am also going to go over some other types of strikes in the bag that aren't just from Western boxing or from Muay Thai or any, you know, kickboxing. So the basic... or one of the basic concepts here is that, well, let me back up for a second. First of all, I have this is at my home, at my dojo. I've got nice big long banana bags. Here I got one of these little 50-pound guys. I actually like these bags quite a bit because of the fact they move. Some people don't like that bag, like the fact that their bag moves. But the movement gives you something to work with. And, you know, like I've told my students, too, that, you know, each bag, there's all these different kinds of training tools and bags. And so, you know, they're meant to be, or you should consider the idea of using the attributes of the bag that you're using. So a freestanding bag obviously doesn't move. So you have to move with it, or you have to move around it, right? You have to, you know, put yourself into it. And you also can pull off a few things on a freestanding bag, you know, that you might have a harder time on a swinging bag, right? Etc. If you have a small bag, if you have one of those headhunter bags, each bag kind of offers different opportunities, right? Different training methods, right? But the general idea with a bag that moves, one of the main concepts is using that movement to, you know, kind of motivate you or give you the stimulus to move yourself. So a really simple example is if the bag comes at me, I'm just going to work on my side-to-side shuffle, right? You know, so like if you could, from this angle, okay, here, right, I'm just going to move off the line, right? It swings at me, I want to step out. Now, as I'm doing that, it's very important that I'm mindful of my stance, okay? So I don't want to, when I step, I don't want to get my feet crossed up, I don't want to lose my base, right? So one real simple thing is just using that movement, right, to kind of push you, give you that stimulus to move off the line, okay? The other thing that you see people do sometimes, I think beginners especially, is that they just kind of start everything in range of their bag. So you never really spar that way or hit pads that way, and so you don't really want to do your bag work that way too. So I'm usually starting out of range so that I have to make at least one kind of entry, one step. Not always with kicking. Sometimes I can just move my leg into position and kick, right? And again, everything depends on your environment. Like if you don't have that much room, you know, you make the best of it. But if you have a little bit of room here, you know, start just out of one shuffle range, right? Then I might move in for my attack. I'll have to step and then step back out, right? So that's one thing to consider when you start working on the bag, okay? The other thing I always tell people is to, whatever techniques you're using, whether they're punches, you know, we like to, the way we explain punching is that we want to connect these middle two knuckles here, right on the surface, here like that, and we want to make sure that we got a good alignment in our punches. So start everything light and slow, right? Get the feel of the bag that you're hitting and get that alignment, get your timing down, your range down. Too often, I think people get hurt because they go at it too hard right away without really working their form, right? Understanding what good form is. So, you know, start nice and easy, nice and light. Pop off the bag. You see, I want it to be kind of a quick retraction. I'm not trying to blast through the bag necessarily. So there's some basic ideas there. And then also in terms of like I've been doing the Panantukan solo training with the rope and shadow boxing. So on the heavy bag, you know, we can practice all those tools that we use, or other arts usually. It's not just Panantukan, but, you know, the palm strike, right? The hack, right? The hammer fist. The way I like to do my hammer fist is I like to skim it down here like this, right? But, I you know, I don't like that going into it at that angle. You could really crank your wrist. So, again, you want to, whatever the tools are that you're working, you want to start light and build up the pressure. I've made the mistake too many times, so I want to save you from that, where I went at something really hard, like, for instance, using a forearm smash, which is a great tool, But if you do it wrong and you really smash this bag, you got a lot of nerves here, right? And that could really hurt, right? So I want to find exactly what is the amount of pressure that I can use with that on this bag, and how do I have to angle it, etc. But you got to go slow. You got to build it up, right? Build up the impact, so to speak, right? So there's a really short kind of explanation or some ideas about using a swinging heavy bag. And then we'll do some more stuff, specific stuff and combinations and everything like that. So go slow, right? Go slow, go light, and build up your pressure little by little, incrementally, okay? All right, guys, I hope that helps. We'll see you in the next video.